Hi, and welcome to this video about scientific notation. In this video, we will explore what scientific notation is and how to write and compare numbers in scientific notation. First, what is scientific notation? The idea of scientific notation was developed by Archimedes in the 3rd century BCE, where he outlined a system for calculating the number of grains of sand in the universe, which he found to be 1 followed by 63 zeros. His work was based on place value, a novel concept at the time. Scientific notation is simply a way of writing numbers. It is especially useful in expressing very large or very small numbers because it is shorter and more efficient, and it shows magnitude very easily. Every real number can be written as a product of two parts, a decimal part times an integer power of 10. M times 10 to the n, where 1 is less than or equal to m, which is less than 10, and n is an integer. Why 10? Our number system is based on 10, and each place value is 10 times the previous place value. 110 equals 10 ones, 100 equals 10 tens, etc. Let's look at writing large numbers using this notation system. We can write the number 1 as 1 times 10 to the 0. Remember, 10 to the 0 is 1, so this is equal to 1 times 1, which is equal to 1. We can also write the number 13 as 1.3 times 10 to the 1, because 1.3 times 10 is equal to 13. Or we can write the number 134 as 1.34 times 10 squared, because that's equal to 1.34 times 10 times 10. You get 134. Let's look again at Archimedes' findings. He expressed the number of grains of sand in the universe as 1 followed by 63 zeros. We could write that out, but that would take way too long and be highly inefficient. In scientific notation, this would be 1 times 10 to the 63rd power, a much more compact and efficient way of expressing this number. The number of zeros in the gigantic number is represented by the exponent. In the fully written number, it's important to realize that each time we multiply by 10, we move to a new place value. So adding a zero means multiplying by 10. A light year, the distance light travels in a year, is 5,878,600,000,000 miles. Let's express this in scientific notation. Often, this is described as moving the decimal point, which doesn't actually happen. We simply need to count the number of times we multiply by 10. The decimal part is created from the first block that begins and ends with a non-zero number. In other words, the block can contain a zero, but we don't use the zeros at the end. Our decimal must be greater than or equal to 1 and less than 10. So we always start from the ones place. Here we have 5.8786 times 10 to the something power. This is where we count the number of times our decimal is multiplied by 10. We need to count from the decimal we created to the end of the number. So 5.8786 times 10 to the 1 is equal to 58.786. 5.8786 times 10 squared is equal to 587.86. And then 5.8786 times 10 cubed is equal to 5878.6. And so on and so on until we reach 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 5.8786 times 10 to the 12th. So in scientific notation, a light year can be expressed as 5.8786 times 10 to the 12th miles. But what if you wanted to take a number written using scientific notation and change it into standard form? A light year can also be expressed as 9.46 0.07 times 10 to the 15th meters. We can easily change this number to standard form. Start with the decimal part, 9.4607, and multiply by 10 a total of 15 times. This tells us that a light year is 9,460,700,000,000,000 meters. Let's look at a couple more examples before we move on. If I Google light year, I'm given about 7,380,000,000 search results. Let's express this number in scientific notation. So, as you can see, I was given 7.38 times 10 to the 9th search results. On average, there are 3.72 times 10 to the 13th cells in the human body. Express this number in standard form. The exponent 13 tells us that we have 13 numbers after the decimal, which gives us 3.72 followed by 11 zeros. If we multiply this by 10 13 times, we see that there are 37.2 trillion cells in the human body. So now we know how to write large numbers using scientific notation, but what about small numbers? First, let's recall how negative exponents work. For example, 10 to the negative 1 is equal to 1 over 10 to the first power, which is equal to 1 over 10. And 10 to the negative 2 power is equal to 1 over 10 squared, which is equal to 1 over 100. Where positive exponents represent multiplication, negative exponents represent division. Again, the number 1 can be written as 1 times 10 to the 0 power, which is equal to 1 times 1 equals 1. The number 0.1 can be written as 1 times 10 to the negative 1, which is equal to 1 times 1 over 10, which is equal to 0.1. The number 0.01 can be written as 1 times 10 to the negative 2nd, which is equal to 1 times 1 over 10 squared, which is equal to 1 times 1 over 100, which is equal to 0.01. The wavelength of green light is 0.00000055 meters. Let's see this in scientific notation. We begin the same way as with large numbers, creating the decimal from the chunk bookended by non-zero numbers. Our result will resemble 5.5 times 10 to the negative something power. Now, we count the number of times our decimal is divided by 10. 5.5 times 10 to the negative 1 is equal to 0.55. 5.5 times 10 to the negative 2nd power is equal to 0.055. 5.5 times 10 to the negative 3rd power is equal to 0.0055, and so on and so on until we reach 5.5 times 10 to the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, negative 7th power. So in scientific notation, the wavelength of green light can be expressed as 5.5 times 10 to the negative 7th meters. The radius of a hydrogen atom is 2.5 times 10 to the negative 11th meters. We can express this in standard form by starting with the decimal part 2.5 and dividing by 10 a total of 11 times. This tells us that the radius of a hydrogen atom is 0.00000000025 meters. I hope that this video helped you to understand how to work with numbers in scientific notation. Thanks for watching and happy studying.